Welcome back to the channel. I'm Tom Quigley, bringing the latest tips, tricks and techniques for all your contemporary painting and drawing needs, and welcome back to another video. Now today's video is going to be a good one. I'm bringing you a new tutorial, and in this one specifically we're going to be looking at skylines. Now just like all of my tutorials, just because I'm looking at skylines, it doesn't mean you can't incorporate these techniques and skills and put them into your own type of work, such as portraiture, rural landscape, still life, or just abstract in general. Feel free to pick and choose what you want and incorporate it and use what you like in your own work. Now, as always, I like to incorporate an artist, and in this particular one, it goes without exception, and we're gonna be looking at the work of Andy Mercer, who looks at cities in particular, but also looks at skylines and looks at the silhouette of the shapes of the buildings, which I'm going to be using in almost like a repetitive manner in the background, and then incorporate some layers within those using some colors. And we're also gonna be using some sellotape transfers in there too. Now, as I said before, we're gonna bring you a new transfer that I've not shown before, but my God, was it expensive. And I'll talk about that later on in the video. But literally, I bought it from Amazon and it was ridiculous. So if anyone knows how, people might remember letter sets. If you haven't got a clue what I'm on about, it's basically these dry letterings that you scratch through onto the surface, and I'll demonstrate later on in the video how you can use them. But they're just a fantastic, very quick piece of work that you can layer over the top of using letters, numbers, and I just found them really interesting. So that's what I'm gonna be using today, and I've been talking way too much, as usual. So without further ado, let's get on with the video. Okay, so let's dive straight in. And the first thing that you will notice is that I'm using a different size piece of paper. I've just used a A2 piece of paper, just cut a thin sliver from it. Now, also what I'm going through here is some images that I've collected. The majority of them are secondary source images, some of London, some of Salford in Manchester, and I've also got a couple from New York. So this would be quite cool if you wanted to do a little bit of a collage of cities or travel. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is tear into those images and just get rid of the straight lines that you can see on normal photocopies. The reason for that is just don't really look that attractive in pieces of work, and I just want it to look a little bit more natural when collaging them together. Now, as you can see, I've got three here. You can add a little bit more if you wanted to, but the first thing I'm going to do is just arrange them in what I think would look best, as I want to draw in the gaps. So please separate them evenly. And then I'm just using some Pritt stick. You could use some PVA glue if you wanted to, or any glue that you may have to hand, and just make sure they're securely fastened onto the page. Now, as I crack on with that one, next thing that I need to start thinking about is almost how am I going to incorporate these with the rest of the blank spaces on the page. And I'm going to be just using a permanent marker. You can use any brand, such as a Sharpie or the Pentel one that I've got here. Now, what I'm doing here, I'm also looking at Andy Mercer's work, and I'm looking around the buildings that I've got in these images and almost tracing the outline or the silhouette of them, just looking for shapes and patterns that I can see repetitively, and then in the empty spaces, just repeating those patterns or doing patterns that are very, very similar. Now, as I do the first line, you can see now they've started to be a little bit more connected. Now, I don't want to just stick with lines. I'm also going to be looking at shapes that I can see in the buildings. Remember, this is quite abstract. I don't want to do a perfect representation. We're just looking at shape, pattern, form, and line. So here I'm just kind of adding some areas. It isn't realistic. You can use your imagination on this one, but I'm just incorporating, bringing those collage areas and immersing it straight into the page. Now, as I work back into here, you could alternately use a different pen at this stage. I do use one later on in the work, but this is a chisel tip marker, so I can get some thick strokes but also thinner ones as well. Now, as I keep on working back into it, just doing a little bit of continuous line to make it a little bit more interesting, and thinking about how much empty space that I want to keep hold of, and some areas do I want to overlap some of those lines. Now, these lines that I'm doing seem to be very potent in the fact that they are very strong on the page, and I want to knock them back a little bit. So here I'm just going to use some gesso, a primer, any primer would do, and I'm just going to use a piece of mount board or folded card to scrape onto the surface, and this will just knock back the color. It will also
bring together and laminate the collage and the drawing so it feels as one. And you don't want to be doing too thick, just kind of thin vertical and horizontal strokes using the paint. You could actually use the end of it to create some lines or dashes. This will show up later on in the piece of artwork, but nothing too much, and it also would be great surface, a little bit more sturdy to put other materials over the top of it. Now here I'm just using a gel pen. You could use a fine liner, but try and use a permanent one that isn't going to be bleeding, because we are going to be using some drawing inks. You don't want to be using one of those pens because all your drawing will disappear. I'm here, I'm just repeating them patterns that I'm showing you, but almost creating this tracing paper look where the drawing underneath has been pushed backwards, and then you can see these ones in the foreground, just like if you had a skyline, you'd have the forefront of buildings and then the background of buildings too. And I'm just picking out elements through those photocopies, and you can see it's almost making it look like it's my drawing rather than just a photocopy. Now here I'm going to be using some brusho inks. It's the same as drawing inks, and if you've never used brusho inks, I'll put it in the link below. These are powdered inks, and they're really great because they are potent and you can change the strength of them, and there's such a variety of different colours as well, so you can really get some lovely vibrant tones within your artwork. So here I've just got a crimson, and then I've got a yellow or lemon yellow as well, so they're really quite nice and vibrant. I've also got some blue too. Now for this first stage, I'm just going to be playing around with some drips and splashes, to be honest. As it's a skyline and it's got water underneath it, that's the images that I'm going for. I'm kind of just creating some drips, being really experimental, just seeing what kind of looks I can get from it, and kind of not thinking about it too seriously. I want some accidents to happen. That's what's going to make it really interesting. Now, I really quite like some of those types of things on there. You could also give it a bit of a tap on the edge of the table and let the ink kind of fall downwards as well. And you'll see me do that a numerous of times throughout the piece of artwork. There, I'm trying to tilt it into the directions that I want to. So it's not purely experimental. I am thinking about it as well, even though it might look like so. Now, once that's dried, as I say, I've not really picked up on that. Just make sure you dry each stage as well with the primer. That's going to make it a little bit easy for you. Here, I'm using some mount board. I'm going to dip it in the ink, and then I'm going to create some verticals and horizontals. You just get some really nice look of geometrical shapes, which automatically fit with the look of buildings. And I've also done some dashes on there as well to create the illusion of windows. So as I keep on going over those and overlapping them, especially with the red, you might get some tones of purple. Now here, I thought I'd stick within those types of colours, and I'm using a purple ink and using some bubble wrap. You could use a vast array of different things, such as other printing materials, to create some squares. I only had this to hand, but I thought it fitted quite nice. And again, let areas dry, and here I'm just putting some yellows in, which would also create some other harmonious colours, such as the green. Now, a few more splashes on there, and we're going to be ready for the next stage. As you can see there, just splashing it on the page there. Now, I've got some magazine cuttings. I've tried to pick out colours that are working in my work. And what I'm going to do is cut up these and place them in some of the sections that I've created pattern. And this is just going to add another layer to the piece of artwork, but also a little bit more of a richness. Now here, as a medium to stick them down, I'm using a structure gel. This is what I just had to hand. Any form of medium, to be honest, if it's acrylic based, will work, and it will also, you know, protect that surface on top of it. So here you can see I'm just doing some squares. I think my ones are a little bit too big, to be honest. You could make them a little bit smaller in your piece of artwork. But to be honest, you know, I'm just playing around with some elements on there. And this kind of inspiration came from an artist called Mark Bradford. He's an LA artist from America. And I really love how he uses it within his work. He actually sands down the artwork in there as well. So I'll put a link below so you can find his work. So that's me all done with the collage. Now, the next stage of what I'm trying to work on is basically still using that collage. I don't want to dismiss it, but I am going to be putting another layer of collage on using the sellotape transfer. Here I'm using a wide strip. I get a lot of questions asking me, what is sellotape? It's basically just parcel tape, you know, transparent parcel tape, to be honest. And just make sure I've kind of make sure it's integrated into the surface using a ruler so there's no air bubbles. Now I've cut around that, and I'm going to turn it over and just wet it just with water in my hands. You could use a paintbrush if you wanted to, and let that water soak in a little bit. Now, with a little bit more of a rubbing technique in there, you'll rub the paper off, revealing a very clean, nice looking image on the other side. Now, you can be quite rigorous with this. You've got to make sure you get all the paper off for the best results. Now, it should be sticky on the other side, but I'm going to be using the gloss medium again, sorry, a structure gel medium, to stick onto the page there. That's basically so I can paint over the top of it and I can do other materials. Because this is a plastic-based thing, you'd find it difficult if you were putting any materials over the top of it. So by putting a acrylic medium over the top, you should be able to apply maybe acrylic or any other materials that you have to hand. So as I work back in here, I've cut them in half so I can separate them, and I'm just putting them in the gaps that I feel are a little bit empty, to be honest, and kind of looking at the colours below as well, just seeing what would work. And I've just got a couple in there just to see what would be the best results in there. Now we're about to move on to the final technique, and this one is called Deca Dry lettering. Now, as I said before, I'm used to using letter sets, and this is very, very similar. So you get a sheet of many different, you know, full alphabet. And what I'm going to be doing is putting words that relate to the city, such as urban, building, metropolis, those types of things. But as you can see, I got one sheet of it and it cost me £8.50. I couldn't believe the price of it, but I did want to show you just in case you wanted to have a go yourself. And if you can maybe find anywhere that does it cheaper, then make sure you purchase them, because they are a fantastic addition to your artistic supplies. And as I just carry on working back into there, just thinking about all the different words that relate to buildings, they actually kind of start looking like buildings the way I've started placing them. So I thought that was quite a nice addition to the artwork. And just to finish off, I've just started to put some extra collage on because I felt like it needed it. And that's it. I think I've just left it as it is. I could always add to it. I could even cut around it if I wanted to, which would be really quite nice. I could even do a concertina piece of artwork, which I was contemplating, but I decided to leave it just as a nice panoramic piece of artwork. And just before I finish completely, just as a final touch, I decided to add some white gel pen. This was just to give some highlights in there, just to add over the collage, just break up the monotony of there, of the dark and the black. It just helps, and I think it looks really quite nice. I think it's a pretty decent piece of artwork.
Well, that's it, guys. Another tutorial done and dusted. Hopefully you found it enjoyable as always and you found it informative. And if you have, let me know below. Comments are always welcome. And if you like this video, please give us a like. It helps the video travel across the YouTube platform. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel for plenty more content, looking at techniques, looking at processes, and enjoy the journey that I'm on as well. I'm off my way home now. I've finished for the day, and hopefully I've kept you creative for the weekend. Let me know, and I'll see you very soon. See you later. Bye.